Next up, Maria in Santa Clara, California, listening to Immaculate Heart Radio. Hello, Maria, and welcome to the program.
Hi. So my question is, I understand, so if you are baptized, you become a child of God, right?
Right.
So, but that's kind of like saying, well, so if you're not baptized, then you're not a child of God, meaning, like, are you not loved as the much or the same way?
Very good question.
Than a baptized person?
Yeah. Okay, so there is, first of all, it's not that you're not loved by God, okay? Because God is creator and he has to love all of his creatures. Inasmuch as he loves himself, he loves his creatures, those that he creates. But there is a distinction to be made between the relationship that God has with his creatures by virtue of creating them and the relationship that he's going to have with those human beings that are baptized and receive the sanctifying grace. There is a new, we say in theology, an ontological difference there between, that is to say, the reality of the soul before baptism is different than the reality of the soul afterward. The soul before baptism has this stain of original sin. It's not considered a child of God in the sense of this familial relationship. Through baptism, that stain is removed, sanctifying grace or supernatural life is given, and the individual enters into a familial relationship with God, whereas the relationship is no longer creator to creature, but it's father to son or father to daughter. So there's a new relationship that begins after baptism. So in short, to answer your question, there is a distinction to be made between the relationship between God and the person before baptism and the relationship between God and the person after baptism. Now, Maria, this brings up another great point, because sometimes, it's important to remember this, sometimes you will find people talk about every human being a child of God, right? Pope Francis did it in a video a few months back. Many other holy people have said that. Now, when they say that, there is room for referring to all human beings as a child of God in a loose sense. The Catechism actually refers to all of humanity as children of God. And unfortunately, Maria, this the paragraph is slipping my mind right now. But there is room in using the language or the terminology of a child of God as applying to not even non-baptized creatures of God, that is, human beings created by God. But there is, in the catechism, in the tradition of the church, this sort of technical understanding of a human being a child of God, namely by receiving the sacrament of baptism. So does that help, Maria? Do you have any follow-up questions on that?
Yeah, so basically the huge distinction is a person who's not baptized can't receive sanctifying grace.
Well, it's not that they can't receive it, because they could if they get baptized, but they don't have they don't have the sanctifying grace in the soul. Now, this is something that it is a mystery, but the church does teach that had Adam and Eve remained in divine intimacy, as the Catechism puts it, they would have transmitted to us a human nature with the sanctifying grace. But because they sinned, because of the original sin of Adam and Eve, consequently, we receive a human nature void of that sanctifying grace because they forfeited that divine gift. And this is why we get baptized, in order to get it back. So thanks be to God for Jesus Christ of restoring that original likeness.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Maria.